it's, you know, more and more we're having sort of women-based stories. And what's extraordinary about Ruth Paxton that directed A Banquet is she really, really, really tangibly understands the female psyche. And so A Banquet is this sort of off-the-wall exploration into all these extraordinary things that could be real and might be real. And I guess the epistemology of what is real and what belief is. And, you know, in the wake of the pandemic, I think it's very easy to understand that everybody's searching for some kind of belief system or some kind of way of making a difference or feeling special. And it's very much an exploration into whether that's possible and the ways of controlling how you feel and parenthood and family. And it's also very surreal, but very beautiful. I mean, there's a lot, we talk a lot about our relationships with food, which is obviously always a massive struggle for any kind of person. A human is like, you know, what is your relationship with food? Do you feel like it controls you or do you control it? And it's very much about control. So you've got this family system where we're in the wake of a tragedy. So Jessica Alexander plays Betsy, and Betsy is the stoic, grounded center stone of this family rather than the mother. And it's this kind of extraordinary play for power and the hoops that she puts me through to make her, make me believe in her, and that she feels that she's special for a certain reason and that she rules that apply to other people don't apply to her, because she's been touched by the moon. And it's this sort of tangible kind of relationship with body and food. And, you know, as a parent, you kind of, you want to feed, because that's what mothering is. You know, you want to nurture and have people grow. And when that's taken away from you, it's like the rug's ripped out from under you. And suddenly when you don't need to eat, you become all powerful in a way, because nobody can control you. So it's about sort of power games. And also, you know, food is a very sensual thing, but it's so tied up in female psyche and always has been, that it's kind of a timeless story of control and belief and food.